Something that became clear to me as soon as I started to engage with NewGround was that Islam and Judaism both see being compassionate as one of the greatest of virtues, which is why I thought it would be perfect to have them get involved in the Compassion Games, Survival of the Kindest, which is an intervention taking place all around the globe. But this past March, it took place at the first school in LAUSD called the Roybal Learning Center, which is a high school in downtown LA. Similar to NewGround, the games are all about building community and empowering others to create social change and strengthening communication and empathy. So during the first week of the games, it became clear to me that it was super important to have discussions that would add greater depth and meaning to their understanding of even what compassion is all about. So this is where NewGround played a critical role. During the second week of the games, several people from the organization came in and spoke to different classes.
This is a beautiful project, and I am proud to be a supporter and participant in the Compassion Games. I think anytime you encourage kindness and compassion between individuals, whether you're talking about our prison system, our school system, or just in our neighborhoods in general, I think it's a very positive step, and it's a way to encourage community and to build a sense of togetherness that will benefit everybody. And I'm very excited to see where this goes, and I think the sky's the limit.
Daniel Hausman came and spoke about music and compassion and how a variety of different artists have reached out to people through lyrics and melodies of compassion, hope, and solidarity.
Mother, there's too many of you crying. Brother, there's far too many of you dying. You know we've got to find a way to bring some loving here today. Yeah. Father, we don't need to escalate. You see, war is not the answer, for only love can conquer hate. You know we've got to find a way.
I am really passionate about this work because I think that it is all rooted in compassion, that it's rooted in the idea of taking a moment to realize that people's fear and ignorance is oftentimes the result of confusion and a lack of information, more so than it is from hatred or mistrust. But those two things become very easily blended together when people feel frustrated or feel emotional or, you know, over other things that might be going on.
So I was being strategic in having Adina speak to a particular class to help out with a situation involving bullying where there was both the person being bullied and the one doing the bullying. Following the presentation, I met with the student who was being bullied and conveyed to her that the other student, and similar to others that bully, was having a tough time with domestic violence. I knew the presentation was a success when the student being bullied shifted her views and she said to me, "I wish she would just tell me what's going on so that I can be there to listen and possibly even be a friend." The empathy she developed helped her to better cope with the situation and not personalize as much.
My cohort, Sarah Schulklapper, and I were really lucky to be invited by Leah to speak at the Compassion Games. It was phenomenal to be able to speak about Judaism and Islam and through the lens of compassion to an audience of predominantly Catholic students. And what really surprised us is what we found out afterwards, that this class, that's known to be a little difficult, was so engaged by our conversation about two people coming together through from a religion that is separate and different, but we're able to acknowledge one another and show respect and compassion to one another. It was really a great event.
Following Mariam and Sarah's presentation, while speaking with the students, they expressed how they really enjoyed connecting with people from unfamiliar faiths and cultures. Some students said that they didn't know women could be a rabbi or a Muslim in general. And a teacher was raving how he thought it was the incredible chemistry between Sarah and Mariam that made the presentation so effective. Sultan Sharif brought in Kwasim Basir and Julian Gant from his film Bilal's Stand, which you should certainly check out. They came to speak to 9-plus students, which are students who've had to repeat the grade twice. And they came to talk with them about how really pushing through to graduate high school, really working hard, and maybe even making college a goal is a form of self-compassion.
I can't even tell you how grateful I am that people from NewGround came and spoke. Thank you so much for taking a moment and listening about my project.
No one knows what it's like to be the bad man, to be the sad man behind blue eyes. No one knows what it's like to be beneath the stains of time. The feelings disappear. You are someone else. I am still right here. What have I become? My sweetest friend. Everyone I know goes away in the end. And you could have it all.